If you're a gamer, I'm betting at some point you've owned or still have a gaming chair for your setup. After a few months, you probably realized this was not the best decision and began noticing how uncomfortable they can be. So it might be time to kick that thing to the curb and get yourself an actual ergonomic office chair. Trust me, you won't regret it. What's up everybody, how you doing? My name is Chris and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, thanks for clicking on this video. In my channel, I try to provide you my honest opinion and experiences on affordable products to hopefully give you an idea on whether or not you want to purchase it. If this is the type of content you're looking for, then please consider subscribing and tapping that notification bell. In today's video, I'm going to give you my review so far on the Hyken office mesh chair from Staples and talk about why you should consider ditching your gaming chair for an actual ergonomic office chair. So this office chair can range anywhere from $150 all the way up to about $200 depending on where you buy it from and if it goes on sale. You can purchase it from different retailers like Amazon, Staples, and Target. It also comes in red, black, and charcoal. This is the charcoal version. So I've been using this old cheapy gaming chair that I bought off Amazon a few years ago, but since working from home through the pandemic, I've had to sit in this chair for like 8 to 10 hours at a time. It was so uncomfortable. My back would be getting stiff. It was just the worst. I could not wait to get out of this chair. So I knew I had to make a change. Oh, that's so much better. My budget was about $200 to $300 and I looked at a lot of different types of chairs. I was about this close to pulling the trigger on the autonomous Ergo Chair 2. I'm sure you heard of it, but yeah, I went down a couple rabbit holes and I was not liking what I was hearing and seeing on some other videos on YouTube. There was some sketchy stuff going on with the chair. The majority of feedback that I was seeing was it was way overpriced for that chair. But during all my searches, I stumbled across this chair, which is exactly why you're here. It was less than $200 and most of the reviews were pretty decent. Had pretty good all-around feedback. So I was like, yeah, why not? Let's go for it. So let's talk about the specifics of the chair and my thoughts. Now this chair has a 7-year limited warranty and it's rated up to 275 pounds. The assembly was super easy and everything is clearly labeled for each step. They even wrap all the screws separately, which makes things even easier. You really can't mess this up and it took me about 20 minutes or so to get it all put together. In my opinion, the aesthetics of the chair is okay. It doesn't have that wow premium factor, but it makes up for it in other areas. That's one of the reasons why I was so interested in the Ergo Chair 2 because it just looks so damn sexy and premium. Now the build quality is really good so far. I've been using it for about 3 weeks and there's no creaking, squeaking, or beeping. It's mostly made up of plastic besides the main components like the hydraulic and seat adjustments. The mesh fabric is really soft, flexible, and strong. It just kind of contours to your body. It's really comfortable and you kind of forget that you're not even sitting on a cushioned chair. The mesh fabric is definitely the way to go. The armrests have a firm rubber and they're not too soft, but they're not too hard. It's kind of in between, but they don't seem to bother me and you can easily put on those cushions if you wanted something softer. Now on the Hyken mesh chair, you can make a few different adjustments that'll make it a little bit more comfortable and fit your body better. The first one is going to be the armrest. You really only can make one adjustment. You can either go higher or lower and it's very simple. All you need to do is push down on the button here. I already have it on the high setting. I usually do it with my palm. So you just push the button and you can go lower or higher. And that's pretty much it. And you could do them both at the same time. I don't have any issues doing them with just my palm and my hands. And to raise and lower the chair, there's a little lever here on the right hand side. All you have to do is pull it up and you'll hear the hydraulic. There you go. Very standard. It doesn't feel any different than any other hydraulic on a chair. Yeah, I don't know the min or max height of the chair when you raise or lower it. Maybe I'll try to find it and put it somewhere on the screen for you. Now, the other adjustment you can make is on the reclining portion itself. You can actually kind of rock on it if you want to, and you can also lock it into the position. So let's say you want to watch a movie or play a game or whatever. You can actually use the lever on the left-hand side here. All you need to do is put it to the position you want. So if I go maybe about halfway here, push it down and then release it and you'll hear it click and there you go. It's pretty much locked into that one place. And then if you want to unlock it, all you gotta do is pull the lever and then put a little weight on it. Boom, you're right back to where you were. I don't know the amount that it reclines, but you can't like lay down on it. You can't go any more than this right here. Now the adjustment you can make is on the headrest. You can like kind of angle it to a certain position if you want, depending on how your head, you know, rests on the chair. So for instance, if I go a little bit higher, I think this would be better if you're like reclining, and then you can go a little bit lower. There's only like really three positions. You can't actually like raise or lower the headrest. So it kind of just depends on how tall you are and where your head lives. I usually just leave it like right here, more or less. There's also a knob here to tighten or loosen the tension of the reclining. So you can have it to be a little bit stronger or looser depending on how you like to recline. Now the final adjustment you can make is on the lumbar, which is directly in the back here, and you have three different positions you can put it on. So I can raise it all the way up here and you'll hear it click, and then you can go all the way down, and that's as far as it can goes, which sits kind of like right on my lower back, which is perfect for me. And the chair is pretty solid. Like I'm not able to tilt it over or anything. There's not like any major squeaking going on yet. I'm sure after a few years there might be some squeaking, but now it's pretty good. So just so you have an idea here, I'm about 5'10", 5'11", and I weigh about 170 pounds. And if you look here in the headrest, my head just kind of fits there just barely, just a little bit over the headrest portion. It fits perfectly for me, but if I was a little bit taller, like maybe 6'1", 6'2", I think I would have a hard time being able to rest my head here in the headrest. It would be more in my neck than anything. In my opinion, if you're a bigger person or a taller person, I don't think this chair would be for you. One, of course, being the headrest. If you're a little bit taller, you're not gonna be able to fit your head on the headrest. And also on the seat and in between the arms, you know, I have maybe about 2 to 3 inches on each side here. Seat portion, I have like maybe 1.5 or 2 inches until like you hit the plastic part. Fortunately, I think this chair is better fit for somebody on the slender side. So after 3 weeks of working and gaming in this chair, I'm really happy with my purchase so far. My body is much happier now. My back is not so stiff. My body isn't hurt at the end of the day after sitting on it for hours on end. And I can easily recline whenever I need to, if I need to take a break or maybe ponder some things, just sitting here. Now, it doesn't have all the adjustments that you would get on those higher end chairs, nor does it have that fancy premium look to it. But it's functional, it's affordable, and it's pretty comfortable. And in my book, that's a win. Why does reclining feel so good? Now, the only gripes I have with this chair is on the tension knob. No matter how much I tighten it up, it doesn't feel like any stiffer or harder to do the reclining portion. I like it to be a little bit harder than what it is right now. I can easily put like barely any effort to it, and it's almost like a rocking chair. No matter how much I turn that knob, I have it like all the way up to the most possible point of tension. It doesn't seem like it does anything. Also, when you take everything out of the box, there's a pretty strong chemical smell coming from all the different parts. Luckily, it kind of went away after a few days, but yeah, it was kind of stinky there for the first few days. So the problem I see with gaming chairs is they always design them as some type of racing inspired design. There's just always very little adjustments. I mean, this is some cheapy one. There's like only 2 adjustments. You could do like the height, and I think there was like a little bit of lumbar support here, but other than that, there's no other adjustments on this chair. Everybody has different body types and different heights and weights. In my opinion, this is why you should consider ditching your gaming chair for ergonomic office chair. You're just gonna have more adjustments and something that's gonna contour to your body and promote better posture. It's just gonna be better for your body in the longer run. If you're still using a gaming chair and you find yourself getting uncomfortable and having body aches, then I highly recommend you check out this chair or any other ergonomic office chair. If you're interested in this Hiken mesh chair, I'll drop the link in the description below. If you do decide to purchase this chair using my link, it does help support the channel and more future content at no cost to you. If you did enjoy this video, please don't forget to smash that like button to help me out with that algorithm. That's it for this video, everybody. I will see you next time. See you.